Hi, good day all of you. Welcome to our session. Welcome to our channel, Intelligible Tutorials. Now, here we are going to talk about the AI problems. State space, problem space, and search space. We define each and everything one after another. So before going to these definitions, first we are going to see how an AI problem can be solved. How to solve an AI problem. So to solve the artificial intelligence problem, first we have to define precisely. Define it precisely. That means each and every artificial intelligence problem can have the starting state and the goal state or the final state. You have to define the each and every state. From the starting state to the goal state, what are the number of intermediate stages? All these states you have to define. Okay. So start state to goal state. Okay, the next one, you collect some set of the problem solving techniques. Set of problem solving skills or techniques. And the third one is, you can use some domain knowledge also to solve that particular problem. Domain knowledge means, for example, it's a mathematical problem, you can solve with the help of the available formulas. Like that, you can use the domain knowledge also. And the last one is, select any one of the appropriate problem solving technique to solve that particular problem in that given domain. Okay? Any technique in that domain. So in this way, you can solve a particular problem which is given to you in the artificial intelligence. So here we need to talk about some two different kinds of the problems. The first one is the 8 puzzle and the second one is water jug problem. Okay, before going to that, we see the definitions of state space, problem space and search space. Okay, first we see the 8 puzzle problem. It's an 8 puzzle problem. So it's 8 by 8. So initially all the whites are here, all the whites are here and all the blacks are here. So after one move it comes here, it comes here. After next move again it changes. That means this is the first state and again in the second state and again in the third state and again in the final state. How it will be, that will be described with the help of the diagram. Okay, so stage number 1, the board is like this. Stage number 2, one black is here, one white is here. Okay, stage number 3, one black here and one white here. Stage number 4, 2 or 3 blacks here, 2 or 3 whites here. Like that, the moves, according to the game moves, you can move one point to the another point, one after other movements. So finally, the state of the board will be changed. There is a lot of difference from starting state or initial state to the goal state of the board. If we arrange all these screenshots of the board from one state to another state in an order like this, that is called the state space. Okay, so from the initial state to the goal state, it may be 8-puzzle, it may be a chess, or it may be tic-tac-toe, whatever problem it is. From the initial state to the next state and to the next state, all the intermediate states which leads to the final state, you reach the final state, you can arrange all these things. This is called as the state space. State space is nothing but the representation of the states of a given problem from the initial state to the goal state or the final state. That is nothing but the state space. And the next one is called as problem space. What is a problem space? Now we are going to see. See a problem space. You have given a large problem, 18 plus 22 plus 16 plus 20. You have to add all these things. 18 plus 22 is nothing but 30. 30 plus 16, 46. 46 plus 20 is nothing but 66. So the total is nothing but 66 here. So initially where we started at 18. After 18, addition of 22, it becomes 30. And again, after 30, you add 16 to that, it becomes 46. And after 46, you add 20 to that, it becomes 66. So what is the initial state here? This is the initial state. This is the final state. So this is a problem actually. This is not a state like the board problems like chess or 8-puzzle or tic-tac-toe. This is a different one. Here states are not there. The states of the problem are there. Hence it is called as such a kind of the mathematical problems. It is called as problem space. We can define it as the problem space. Whereas in the previous case, we are representing the states, the moves initially, how they are without moves. After one move, the status will be changed of the state and of the board. The third move, the state of the board will be changed. Like that, till you reach the final, it will be totally changed. If you arrange all these screenshots, that's different. That is state space. Here it is called as the problem space. You started at initially 18, you ended at 66. By addition of all these three numbers intermediate, these are the intermediate values you got. So while adding these three. So this is the example of the problem space. Now we see what is a search space. Search space means you are searching in a tree. C, A, B, C, D, E, F, G. My goal is this. This is my initial state. This is my goal state. From the initial state to the goal state, I started my search from A to B, B to C, C to F, F to G. Like that, I started my search. So, A to B, B to C, C to F, F to G. Whereas A is the initial state here and G is the goal state here. So you are searching for a solution in a given tree, in a hierarchical tree, then it is called as the search space. That means you started at A node and you came to here, you came here, you came here, you came here. This is the goal node. Like that, you traversed the tree from initial state to the goal state. Hence it is called as search space. See now how the words are different. State space, problem space and search space. State space, what are the examples for the state space? 8-puzzle, chess. What are the examples for this problem space? Water jug problem, which now we are going to see. Okay, so what is the search space here? Is nothing but search techniques. Searching on a tree. Search tree. Likes. So like this we have the different kind of the terminology in artificial intelligence like state space, problem space, search space. And the problem can be solved before I discuss the four kinds of the techniques. The problem can be solved like this. After this break, we start a new one called water jug problem, which is a very good example for this problem space. How the problem space can be represented very precisely from initial state to the goal state, that can be explained with the help of the water jug problem. So before going to that, we take small break, then we continue. Okay, now we start with the water jet problem. In the water jet problem, we have initially 5 liter and 2 liter jugs are given. That means you have given two jugs. One is the capacity of the 5 liters and another one is the capacity of 2 liters. One is 5, another one is 2. And 5 liter is full and 2 liter is empty. You have given 5 liter is full of water and 2 liter is empty. And the next goal is you have to do 2 liter jug has exactly 1 liter and 5 liter with 0. 5 liter does not contain any kind of water and 2 liter contain exactly 1 water. How to solve this problem? With the help of the artificial intelligence, by using the problem space, we can solve this particular problem with the help of these production rules. There are some set of the rules are given. These are called as the production rules. Look at these production rules. X comma y, 0 comma y. X comma y is equal to x comma 0. X comma 2 is equal to x plus 2 comma 2. X comma 0 is equal to x minus 2 comma 2. 1 comma 0 is equal to 0 comma 1. So these are the 5 different set of the rules that we have given. Okay. So now what we are going to see is we will apply these rules to our problem. Okay. So what is the initial state we have here? What is the initial state we have here? Is nothing but 5 comma 0. That means 5 liter is full and 2 liter is empty. So this is nothing but the initial state. Okay. To this initial state, I am applying which resembles to 5 comma 0. Let us consider 5 comma 0 as x comma 0. Okay. So I will take this x comma 0, rule number 4. So what is the rule number 4 is saying? Applying rule number 4 here. So that is 5 comma 0 is equal to x comma x minus 2 comma 2. That is nothing but x minus 2 means 3. 3 comma 2 I got. Okay. And again this 3 comma 2, this is the step 1. And in the step 2, in the 3 comma 2 resembles what? This one. 2. X comma y, x comma 0. So rule number 2, that is 3 comma 2. 3 comma 2 I am applying rule number 2. Then it becomes what? 3 comma 0. Again this 3 comma 0 resembles what? Rule number 4. So what it is saying, rule number 4 is x comma 0 is equal to x minus 2 comma 2. Okay, so what I have to write here, x minus 2 means 1 comma 2 it is. Again 1 comma 2 resembles what? X comma y. So that is nothing but x comma y means what? X comma 0. 1 comma 2 is equal to 1 comma 0. So directly 1 comma 0 rule number 5 is there to this. You applied here rule number 4. Again rule number 4 you have applied here rule number 2. And this rule number, after application of the rule number 2, you applied rule number 5. That is nothing but 1 comma 0 directly becomes 0 comma 1. Okay. Like this you have applied initially from starting state to the goal state. You applied like this. That is initially 5 comma 0. That is initial state you have applied rule number 4. 5 comma 0 becomes x comma 2. Rule number 4 x comma x minus 2 comma 2. That becomes 3 comma 2. 3 comma 2 resembles what? Rule number 2. So 3 comma 2 becomes x comma y becomes x comma 0. So it becomes 3 comma 0. So after application of this again 4, rule number 4, you have applied x comma 0. If 3 comma 0 resembles x comma 0, again it is x minus 2 comma 2. That becomes 1 comma 2. Again you apply rule number 2. It becomes what? 1 comma 0. So after application of the rule number, this one is 1 comma 0 becomes 0 comma 1. You will see once again this. Clearly. By using these production rules. Okay. See here, I will write once again. The initially you have given 5 comma 0 and goal is nothing but 0 comma 1. Understand? 5 comma 0 and 0 comma 1. So now see, initially it is 5, 0. To this 5, 0, you applied rule number 4. After application of rule number 4, it resembles x, 0, that is x minus 2, 2. Then it is 3, 2. Okay. So, this is the step 1. Coming to the step 1, the 3, 2 resembles what? Rule number 2. So, x, y is equal to x, 0. So, 3, 2 becomes 3, 0. So, 3, 0 resembles again rule number 4. So, what rule number 4 is saying? 3, 0 is equal to 3 minus 2, 2. That is 1, 2. Again, 1, 2 resembles what? X, y. That is 1, 2 is equal to 1, 0. So, 1, 0, directly it is there. 1, 0 is equal to 0, 1. Like that, you applied how many rules? Here, initially you applied rule number 4. And here you applied rule number 2, and again you applied rule number 4, again you applied rule number 2, and again you applied rule number 5. Like this, this is the rule sequence. Now we see what is the problem space here. Okay, so for this, the problem space is, what is the starting one, initial state here? This is nothing but 5, 0 is the initial state. 5, 0 to what we reached? 3, 2 we reach 3, 0. So again to 3, 0 we reach 1, 2. 1, 2 we reach 1, 0. 1, 0 to we reach 0, 1, which is the goal state, which is the initial state. This entire thing is called as what? Problem space. Okay, we solved a problem by using certain number of the rules. So what is the rule sequence? Rule sequence means the application of the rules. Initially, you applied the rule number 4, again you applied the rule number 2, again you applied the rule number 4, again you applied the rule number 2, finally you applied the rule number 4. This is called the rule sequence. Okay, for this, what is a problem? And this is called the problem space. Problem space means what? Initial state, again you got 3, 2. Again you got 3, 0, again you got 1, 2, 1, 0, 0, 1. So 5, 0 to 0, 1, you got these number of the intermediate states. How many? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 number of the intermediate states you got. Hence this is called as the problem space. This is called as the problem space of water jug problem. This is the rule sequence of the water jug problem. So this is the best way to represent a problem in the way of solving by application of the set of the rules. A problem can be solved by using this collection of the rules. Okay. So this is the best example of the water jug problem. Once again I will explain. Please listen. That is initially 5, 0. You apply the rule number 4. What is the rule number 4? It resembles x, 0 is equal to x minus 2, 2. Hence it becomes 5 minus 2, 2, 3, 2. Okay. So, 3, 2 resembles rule number 2. Rule number 2 is x, y. X, y is nothing but what? X, 0. Okay. So, 3, 2 becomes 3, 0. So, 3, 0 again resembles the rule number 4. X, 0. So, it becomes 3, 0, which is nothing but x minus 2, 2. That means 3 minus 2, 2. That is 1, 2 we got. Okay. So, 1, 2 again resembles rule number 2. X, y is equal to x, 0. So 1, 2 is equal to 1, 0. 1, 0 rule number 5 directly it is there. That is 1, 0 is equal to 0, 1. I applied directly the rule number 5. Like that, you can use this rule set to solve this water jug problem. Okay. In the artificial intelligence, the water jug problem can be solved like this. If you like this video, please subscribe Intelligible Tutorials. And if you got any doubts on this, please mail to intelligibletutorials@gmail.com. Thank you.